After the pain goes and all the tears flow, when there is no one, go one. What's going on, you guys? Welcome. I am Royal Desno, back with another Minecraft episode. And today we actually have a ton of work to do. I actually want to start finishing up my wall. Maybe not finish it all the way, but you know, at least get started on it, because I haven't worked on that for a long time. As you can see, I did just a little bit here and there. It's been so long that I actually kind of forgot how to build this wall, if that makes sense. Like figuring out, yeah, I don't even remember how I'm going to do like a straight tower where there's a tunnel going through it, a hallway going through it. So I know how to do the corner ones, well, probably not anymore, just because it's been so long since I've built anything on this world. So if I come in here, see, I don't remember any of this. I don't know how to do this. I did this all on the spot. I mean, this design just came to me while I was building it. So like to replicate it again after like a couple months, no, I don't know about that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna pull up my laptop right here. Gonna get a copy of this world file and put it in there, and then put that one in creative mode so I can fly around in that game, and so I can take a look at it and replicate what I've been doing, because I honestly forgot how to build my own castle. That's kind of, I mean, like, would you memorize something like that? I just don't have it memorized, so I have to kind of look it up, just look at how things are built, and then do the same thing. But yeah, as you can see, I have a bunch of stuff cooking in these furnaces. I have all my cobblestone and all my stone, just, yeah. And then over here, I got all my building supplies. I already went ahead and pre-made a lot of this stuff, but here's a chest just full of stone bricks, more stone bricks, stone brick slabs, stone slabs, stone brick stairs. That's nothing. Got my cobblestone walls for these pillar things right here. And in this one, I've just got stone. So I have this one, which is smelting all this cobblestone for me. So that's what that's doing. I got coal in there, and it's just throwing it all into this chest. So I have these going, and then I have that automatic smelter going. So I will have lots of building supplies. I don't think I need to mine anymore, because even if I do run out, these chests are full of cobblestone, and so are these chests. This place is getting really crowded. That's why I need to start building my buildings, so I can sort all this stuff away, because none of this is going to be here when my castle's done. None of this right here. Not even that little dinky house that I built. Oh, before I forget. Oh, before I talk about the horses, because I just remembered something else while I remembered the horses. If someone told me to type /seed because they wanted the seed for this world, so for whoever you were, I forgot who you were, there you go. There's the seed right there in the bottom left corner. If you can't read it, it's -7846960089. So that's the seed to this world. And yeah, cool beans. So yeah, let me actually talk about my horses, because this is exciting. So I went and gathered a bunch of new horses. As you can see, I got a bunch of new little buddies. None of them have names yet though, but these are pretty good horses. I'm gonna show you my two favorite ones, and then we'll call that good, and then we'll start building or something. Get out of the way. Okay, so this white one right here, this white one has three things of hearts, and it jumps four blocks high, and it's pretty fast. I mean, look at this. I feel like I'm running around pretty fast. There's a little bit of server lag, but excluding that, this horse runs pretty dang fast. It has a good amount of health, which is a plus, of course. And yes, it does jump four blocks high. So if I come over here, yep, see? Four blocks cleared. Easy. Easy peasy. Okay, and then my second horse that I got, which is another favorite, is, oh my gosh, I want to be on this side, is this black one that looks like a cow. This one, it doesn't have as many hearts, but holy crap, can this horse jump. This horse can jump 5.5 blocks high. That was 5.5 blocks right there. That's what this horse can do. Boom, look at that. 5.5 block horse that can jump that high.
Its speed, it's not as fast as the white one, but still, it's pretty dang good speed for how high it can jump. So this one can jump 5.5 blocks high, and it's pretty fast. I think the white one's faster and jumps 4 blocks, but still, that's good. The white one has more health, too. I tried breeding them together, and I got that white horse right there, but it's not as good. And I did do a test on breeding horses one time because I was going to make a video on how to breed a super horse. But I came to the conclusion that when you breed horses, so if you have one that has really good jumping, like 5.5, and then one that has 4 jumping, the off-breed will usually have something between the two of them, like a medium between the two of them. And for all the stats as far as like health goes and speed, because I set up like a little speed course to time how fast they run, it seems the off-breeds, like no matter how many more generations you breed, it just kind of creates a medium of the two horses. So there's really no way to increase the stats of a horse through breeding. So I came to the conclusion that to breed a good horse, actually you can't breed a good horse, the best way to do it is just to find a good one in the wild. So that's my thought on that. Maybe it's changed since I tested it, but who knows. But yeah, I got a mule, which is cool. He's just chilling here. He's pretty fast since I breeded the mule and I think the white horse together, so that created a pretty decent mule. Okay, so enough talking about that. Let's actually start building. So I'm gonna go build a ton and then I will check up on you guys, and I might do a montage, maybe not, I don't know, it kind of depends. I don't know what to do a montage on because I've already done montages of me building the wall, so I might not even do that. I'll probably just build a lot and then I'll check up on you guys and let you guys see my progress, and then we'll kind of go from there. So I'm gonna go off camera for a little bit. I'm gonna go build a ton of crap, just gonna build for like 3 hours straight. It's gonna be pretty great, and hopefully I can get a lot done. So I will talk to you guys in just a little bit. All right, you guys, so I have spent the last 4 hours, maybe even 5, I don't even know, building the wall. And are you guys ready for this? It may not actually look like I've done much, but bam! It's not all the way done, but the whole bottom layer is completed all the way around. It doesn't look like a lot of work from here, but let's go take a run, and then you'll see that it has been a lot of work. So I still need to do the second layer across the whole thing and the towers, and I need to make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like 6 towers. Oh my gosh, that's gonna be quite a chore. But let's check it out. Let's run along this side. So here, that there's one of the towers. There's the base for it. And yeah, there's another base for a tower right over there. And if we come outside, we can take a look at the outside. I've done a lot of work on the outside as well. Let me eat some meat. Okay, so this is what it looks like from the outside all the way around. So it's all done like this. It's all exactly the same, symmetrical to the very last block. Symmetrical, that doesn't make any sense. And then we got, there's that entrance, which is beautiful looking. We got this whole side way over here, all the way down. Here's one of the corner pieces, and keep in mind there's one of these corner pieces on every corner. So there's the corner piece. Pretty beautiful, if I do say so myself. Let's take a run on top, just to show you guys my progress so far. So here's the upper level. I got this completed so far. Here's where one of the towers is gonna be, right here. And then continuing on. Look at this place, looks cool. And then this tower right here, all the way along here. Here's a tower. Oh man, this is great. I don't even know where all this motivation came from to do this tower or this wall, because it was so much work. But I'm about, I don't want to say half, because I feel like the towers are still going to be a chore to make a lot more of those. But let's get one more view, and it's going to be a view from really high in the sky, because I think that's where it looks the coolest. So hold on. All right, I'm all the way really high up in the air. But let's take a look. Wow, it's really starting to come together. Check that out. This is really exciting. It's exciting to see this wall start to go up. Well, I think I'm gonna try and finish this tonight, which is the night that I started recording this. So I'm gonna try and finish building this whole thing tonight. And hopefully, by the end of this episode, it'll be all the way done. All right. Well, I'm gonna go back to work, and hopefully, by the next time I'm up here, it'll be all the way done. So, I will see you guys in just a little bit if I either finish it or if I don't finish it, and then I'll say I'll probably do it next episode. But hopefully, I get it done this episode. I guess we'll find out. So, until then, hold on. Oh my gosh, I almost fell. That was scary. I did it. I can't believe I did it. This took me so freaking long. Keep in mind, I am in a survival game and I do not go into creative for any reason whatsoever. So, I did this all in survival mode and I finally finished. It took me so freaking long. Yesterday, I spent 12 hours on it, and then this morning, let me see, I spent 3.5 more hours on it, finishing it up, and it is finally done, and I finally get to show it off. Are you guys ready for this? Boom. Oh, wait for it to load. Wait for it to load all the way. I'm too far away. There we go. Oh, boom, look at that. This thing was so much work. So much work. It was ridiculous how much work this was. But I finally did it, and I burned through so many freaking resources just to make it. I'm pretty much out. Like, this is all I basically have left. I pretty much ran out, and so I had to start smelting more. And even with the automatic smelter going, I almost ran out of supplies, but I had enough to finish it. And there we go. This thing is symmetrical to the T. There is nothing that is off. It all fits exactly the same. It's all symmetrical. If you were to cut this thing exactly in half right here, it would divide perfectly on both halves. So that is freaking awesome. Oh man, it's so beautiful. But instead of running around showing it to you, I'm actually gonna whatever it's called. I'm gonna go into F1 mode, go into survival or creative, just so I can fly around. I'm probably gonna do it on my laptop, and I will just fly around the castle and give you a cool view of it with a little bit of music. So here we go. Hope you guys enjoy it. I'll talk to you as soon as it's over. So there you guys have it. I hope you guys enjoyed that little montage. It was pretty fun to make, even though it was super fast. Pretty easy to make that. Just throw some music in and call it good. But yeah, anyway, that's it, you guys. I am actually so proud of this. I am so proud of myself. I really didn't think I would get this done in one episode. I thought this was gonna take like, a couple episodes to finish, But I actually completed the whole thing in one go. And like I mentioned, Castle's going to be over in that area. So I haven't connected anything over there yet just because I need to figure out how I want it to be. I think I'm going to have it so that wall comes out a little bit and then connects into the castle. And the castle's going to have like a balcony border that goes around it that connects into this wall, if that makes any kind of sense. But I'm thinking that's what I'm going to do, just right there. Yeah, right there. That would look cool. And then my castle will be right there. And I might make it taller. I might have it like really high up in the air, or maybe I'll just have it on that level. I'm not sure. Oh, but let's get down from this really scary place. Oh my goodness, let's talk about what's next, you guys. So now that I have that outlined, I have a better idea of how much room I have to build with, and that's quite a bit of room there. Quite a bit of room to build with. And that's one building right there, and that was a pretty big building. It's not small by any means. It's a decent sized building. It's not huge, but it's decent. So I haven't decided the layout of the place I'm going to make yet. I know I'm going to have other shops to make, like a mining place. I have a list somewhere of buildings I want to make. And then I'll probably have just like a little area somewhere with just houses, just so I can have houses in here. I don't know what for, but why not? Maybe I'll have some of you guys move in or something. I don't know. But there is one more thing that I wanted to show before I end off this episode. And let's actually go there. It's actually down in my zombie spawner place. So I'm going to go down there real quick. But I don't know. What do you guys think I should do for next episode? Because I finished the wall, which it even surprises me. So I hope you guys really enjoy that. I hope that's something that you guys like, and tell me if you guys like it, that'd be great. But yeah, what to do next, because I finished that. I honestly didn't think I was going to do that in one episode. I just was on a roll, I was motivated, and I just wanted to get it out of the way, so it's finally done. I was thinking I could start building more buildings, I guess. That's basically all that's left, is to build more areas. I mean, it makes sense, right? To build more areas. So I'll probably build some shops. If you guys have any suggestions for any kind of shop you want to see me build or what I should be building next, leave a comment down below and I'll be sure to consider it. But yeah, we're going to start building on buildings, I guess, next, and some cool automated systems. It'll be a good time, you guys. If you guys remember this is my zombie spawner. Basically, I added in this whole back section right over here. Oh, it's so cool. I don't even remember... like why I did this. I just did it because I was so tired of like making potions in this stand that was right here. I was just like tired of making them as I go, so I was just like, you know what, I'm gonna build a potion maker. So this is what was made. So I can take out these potions, bottles automatically fill up, and I can press this button, wait a second, then press this one, wait a second, press this one, and then press that one. And the reason I have it so I press all the buttons is because I like to press buttons. It makes me feel cool, like I'm doing some crazy chemistry. Because I could have hooked it up so I just press one button and it automatically put all these ingredients in, and then it made it. So as you can see, it's making the, what's it called? Awkward potion, and then the glycerin melon to make it a splash, or a healing potion, then that to make it level 2, and then to make it splash. So yeah, that's gonna go through and cook, and then I can just store them over here. And now I can gain experience as much as I would like. So I have my anvils there, my enchanting table to enchant with, and yeah. I'll actually show you guys the inside if you guys wanna see how it's all hooked up. It's not that great, it's not compact or anything, but hey, it works. So here's the inside. Here's where all the bottles are. Here's where I can refill my bottles. And then if we come up here, here's all the items. So here's where the nether warts go. Here's where the melons go. What's that stuff called? Glow dust? Is that what it's called? I don't remember. Yeah, it's called glowstone dust. And then here's what this looks like just back here. Just some simple redstone circuits. Nothing too fancy. And this just goes back to my item sorter that I have for the zombies. But yeah, it's kind of messy back here. It's not nice or anything by any means, but it works. It gets the job done, and that's all I really care about. This isn't, like, gonna be my official potion room or anything. This was just something that I made just for wallets, or for this area down here, just to make that one potion. So when I build my actual potion room in my castle, I think is where I'm gonna put it, or maybe I'll put a potion shop or something in the town. I'm gonna have it so I'll be able to make any potion that I want. I don't think I'm gonna have them be automatic potion makers, just because I want to be able to pick the ingredients. So, like, I'll have a room where step one will be to add the nether wart, step two will be to add my ingredients, and there'll be a list of which ones I can add second, and then I can add my buffs or my things that make them better, and then the gunpowder at last if I want it to be. So I think that's how I'm gonna set up my potion room, and I'll have like one, two, or maybe even three stations where I can just brew potions at by pressing buttons. That's my idea. I might do it that way, because I don't want to set up like a million automatic potion makers, or just have like one and then switch out everything whenever I need to. So I'll probably just make it so I can just press buttons and it'll feed in, and then I can make potions that way. That's my plan. Let me get out of here. And there you guys have it. I think that's where I'm gonna stop the episode, just because we did a lot this episode, and I don't think I'm gonna do a challenge this episode. I'll probably maybe do one of those next episode, depending on what I get done, because I feel like I'm getting lots of great stuff done, that the challenges are just kind of there in case you want to have a little bit extra fun at the end. So maybe next time. But that was the end of my episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun building this castle wall, and it feels so good to be done. So thank you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did enjoy this video, be sure to share it, comment, and tell your friends about it. Tell them that I'm going to be building an awesome kingdom in here, and they'll probably be like, freak yeah! Because I'm going to make this place look really cool. When it's all done, it's going to be pretty great. But yeah, thank you guys once again. I hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to subscribe if you liked. And hopefully we'll have some more content starting to come out pretty soon. As soon as Toothpistle gets married, maybe he'll have more time to record. Maybe. Then we can start doing things and getting more videos consistently rather than like once a week. That's kind of bad. But yeah, hopefully we can get something going, like another series going or something. But yes. Thank you guys, I've been talking so much, but I'm just so excited that this wall's done. Alright, I will talk to you guys later, and Happy New Year's, because you guys are probably watching this on New Year's. So, happy 2014, let's make this a great year. I know that I'm going to try my best to record as much as I possibly can in 2014. It's a goal of mine for this channel, and maybe my music channel, maybe I'll start doing that one. I haven't decided if I really want to do it yet, but maybe I will. Alright you guys, talk to you later. Peace out!